All right, incredible craftsmanship. Look at this, and coordination all coming together to tell a story. These are the Bunraku Bay Puppets performing starting today at the Bridges to Japan exhibit at the State Fair. There's an interesting history, and the troops, Martin Holman is here to talk about that in just a second. But first, we're going to talk with Teresa Kolzak with the Japan-American Society of Indiana, because we got to be out at the State Fair last week together and check out this amazing exhibit. We have some video we want to show. What do you want people to know about the exhibit?
Well, it's important to know that this is the first time that a country has been featured at the Indiana State Fair in what promises to become a new international theme, in which a different country every year with significant ties to Indiana will be showcased. Because there are so many connections between Indiana and Japan, Japan is the first country that is featured. We've brought together just a great lineup of performances, cultural activities, wonderful Japanese food that you can find inside the pavilion, robots from Japan, as well as a lot of educational information about the many connections between Indiana and Japan.
Martin, we want to learn about these puppets and the history as we take a look here live at them in action. First, how did you get involved in doing this?
Mm-hmm. Well, I went to Japan the first time 32 years ago. And I was interested in puppets since I was a little kid. And I got involved with the traditional Japanese puppets with a troupe, 175-year-old troupe, near Kyoto, Japan. And I was the first foreigner to train and perform in Japan in the traditional puppet theater. And I'm a professor at the University of Missouri, and I started taking my students with me to train. And then once I had enough people trained, we decided to form a troupe here and so we could perform it here in the United States.
I'm interested in really the history behind the puppets and what these particular puppets kind of mean to the people of Japan.
Mm-hmm. Well, these puppets are in the form in which, you know, they're performed today. These are about 250 years old, the style of puppetry. And these they were for a performance, they were regular adult theater. Mm-hmm. And this was not a children's theater, although the pieces that we're performing are perfectly good for family audiences and will entertain children. But this was a, you know, a highly developed form of theater that attracted, you know, the average townsman 200 years ago in Japan.
Well, they're beautiful and very interesting. And the puppets right now, the same again, exactly how you say it.
Bunraku.
Bunraku.
Well, that's the American pronunciation.
Well, how would
you
say it in Japan?
Bunraku. Well, it's that R.
Okay. It depends, right? They're
right,
performing
right
now through, if we can scroll that. Can you move that for me? Through Saturday, again, at the Bridges to Japan exhibit, the International Pavilion, right there at the Indiana State Fair. And if you'd like more information, go to fox59.com, check out links. And there are probably specific times that they're there throughout different days.
Right. Okay. Four times a day.
Four times a day you can see them.
Every 2.5 hours.
All right, we'll see you there. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you
for coming
you
in. Very
Thank
interesting,
you.
As always. 9:17.